Now let's talk about bridges. Okay, so what are bridges? So bridges are now at, so repeaters were at physical layer and they just did not check anything. Whatever was coming from one port, it was repeated at all the other ports. Okay, but they were not smart. So now bridges are smart MAC layer device or data link layer device which connects two or more LAN at the link layer. Okay, so they are now connecting two or more LANs. So what is humming becoming there? This is one particular LAN. Okay, this is another LAN and both are connected by a bridge. So this is one port with which LAN 1 is there and with one port LAN 2 is there. So now it processes the packet also. It looks at the packet and sees what is the destination, and only, so let's say this host sends packet which is the destination also resides in this LAN 1. So in this case, when the bridge sees this, it will not forward this packet to LAN 2 because it knows that, okay, the destination of this particular frame is in LAN 1 itself. Okay, so it looks up the destination in the table and forwards the frame to appropriate LAN segment. So when it knows that the destination of that particular frame is here, it will not forward it to LAN 1. Only if the destination is here, it will forward. And each segment can then carry its own traffic and there will be probability of less collision because you are not just forwarding packets to different LANs without seeing if that particular packet will belong here. Okay, so this is there. So this is quite advantageous, okay, because now you're not having a lot of collisions. So link layer, now let's talk about switch. Okay, so what are switches? But let's try to look differently. Okay, so we will look at here. Okay, let's try to see. So we come to a bridge. Okay, so a bridge, what we were seeing, it maintains a table for decisions. So let's look at those decision making table. So we have now a bridge which is connecting two LANs. Okay, so it has two ports. This is our bridge and it has two ports. LAN 1 is connected via port 1, LAN 2 is connected via port 2 to this bridge. And let's assume that for now this LAN 1 has two machines on it and LAN 2 has also two machines, and these are the 48-bit MAC address. So now what it says that it writes, it has a table which says that, okay, if this is the MAC address, then you forward it to port 1. So for example, LAN 2, let's say this machine sends a frame to this one. Okay, so that bridge will have a lookup here. So it's 71 2b 13 45 61 41. So what will it do? It will see that, okay, this is in port 1, so it will forward it to port 1. Okay, so this way it helps. And if it was just to, let's say that 61.12, this particular computer, then it will find 61.12. okay, this is in the same LAN 2 and it will just forward it to port 2. So it will not go out to LAN 1 and it will not cause unnecessary collision. Okay, so this is the beauty. A bridge does not change the physical address in the frame, so it does not change the address, it only makes a lookup for it. Now let's look at, so do we have to fill that particular table which we were looking? So it's quite difficult, isn't it? So now that's why we want the process of making the table to be automated. So here is the learning process for the bridge. So let's look here. So we have a bridge here It has three ports and the three LANs are connected to it. So LAN 1 is on port 1, LAN 2 is on port 2, and LAN 3 is on port 3. Now how does the learning takes place? So what happens is, let's say that A sends a frame to D, okay? So A sends a frame to D, it comes to this bridge, and now initially when the table is not filled, so what will happen is that it will look and it will find there is, it doesn't know where to send D to, okay? So it doesn't know which port D belongs to. So it will forward it now to port 2, port 3, and it will not forward it to port 1 because it is from there the packet frame is coming. But what it knows that the source of this frame is A and it is coming at port 1. So now it writes in the table that okay, A is the at port number 1. So next time when let's say F sends a frame to A, it can easily know that okay, A is at port 1. So this now it doesn't forward it to both 1 and 2 but only to port 1 because it now knows that A resides in port 1. Now let's say second time E sends a frame to A. So E sends a frame to A, E is on LAN 3 which is at port 3 of the bridge. So again, based on the source address and if because it's coming at port 3, it knows that E is on port 3 and it puts it on its table. And then now it also knows that A is at port 1 of the bridge, so it forwards the frame to port A. Similarly, if B sends a frame to C, okay, so it knows that B is at port 1, okay. This way, the learning happens, and after some time, when mostly all the nodes have sent some message of frame, then they will have their table here, okay. And if somehow one new source is there, okay, for which the table is not filled, so then it will forward it to all the ports. So this is how the learning takes place. But there is a problem, okay. What happens is, for reliability and fault tolerance, many people, administrators, okay, what they do, they have two or more bridges for fault tolerance and reliability, but that causes a loop. Okay, so let's try to see what is a loop. So here what happens is, let's say this is LAN 1, there is a bridge 1, bridge 2, two bridges are there, and our administrator wants to make sure that okay, where even if one bridge fails, our packet should be, frames should be moving around. So if this fails, then also packets, frames can go to C and D, LAN 2. But what will be a problem? Problem is of loop. So A sends packet frame to D, then what happens, it comes to bridge 1 because it's also it is received by bridge 2, and both of them now sees that okay, the source is A, so they put in the table, bridge table, that A is coming from port 1. So far well good, and two copies of one from bridge 2, one from bridge 1 comes to LAN 2. Now what happens, from bridge 1 the packet frame comes, it travels to D and C, but because bridge 2 is also on LAN 2, it goes, that packet from A goes to this one also, and now again the source is A, okay, the frame source is A, but now it is for bridge 2, this is coming from port 2, and back frame from bridge 2 also went to bridge 1, and now even though the source is frame A, source is A, it is coming from port 2. So now it updates its address as address A is coming from port 2. So this becomes a problem, and then it passes on the packet to the frame to LAN 1. Then what happens? Again it sees that okay, destination is D, so one frame comes here and it says, okay, the destination is D. So it comes here, but what happens is that again it updates that, okay, from A, the port now from which it comes is A1, and this keeps on continuing. So a loop is created. So we need to see this problem, and what is the solution? The solution is spanning tree. When we have multiple bridge for reliability, we have spanning tree algorithm we apply here, and then what happens is, let's say this is the LAN 1, LAN 4, 2 and LAN 3 are connected by 5 bridges. Okay, so this is very good architecture based on for reliability, that even if this fails, then also let's say between LAN 4 and LAN 3 both of, okay, so what happens, okay, both B5 and B2 fail. Then also if you see, even if this fails, LAN 4 can go via B4 and then B1 to LAN 1. So this is very reliable architecture, but the problem is we might have a loop. Okay, so this is a loop, this one is a loop, this whole thing is causing a loop, and loop is not very preferred because then endless packets or frames are moving around. So what we do is we make, these are now nodes, okay, of a graph. So this is LAN 1, LAN 2. So these we make, and then what happens is we make a graph out of it, and then what we do is that in this graph we find a minimum spanning tree. Okay, so the minimum spanning tree for this particular graph, which was of bridges and LANs, is this one. So now here we remove this edge. B3 is now not connected directly to LAN 3, it's not connected to LAN 4, and B5 is not connected to LAN 3, and this was the root of spanning tree. Okay, so now what happens is, and still the important thing is all the LANs are connected. Okay, so LAN 3 is connected to LAN 1 also, and the hop distance is 1 bridge is needed for the connection. LAN 3 is connected to LAN 3, but now it has to go via B2 and B1. LAN 2 is also connected to LAN 4 via B4, and so on. Okay, so all of the LANs are still connected, but there are no loops, and that is the benefit. But now you will say that, okay, if this will fail, bridge B2, then again we will have a problem that LAN 3 will now get disconnected from all. But then what happens is, even though there is a spanning tree, it's a not a physical, it's a logical spanning tree. Okay, so then they keep on checking, if this gets disconnected, I will put this port on and this connection will become fine, then LAN 3 can come connect to LAN 2 and LAN 1 via B3, it can also connect through this link. Okay, so it kind of keeps checking which link has failed. So what is it called? These ports are now called blocking ports, which are by this dash line. Okay, so these are blocking ports. So forward packets are not forwarded for port 1 of B5, port 2 of B3 and port 3 of B3. Okay, so this is how it happens. So this was about bridge.